Hello everybody and welcome back to our puppet playthrough of Dark Souls, where today we're headed into Blighttown. John, are you ready?
Yeah.
First we gotta kill this dragon. Where we left off last time, we've decided we're gonna kill the dragon, so try to kill the dragon.
Oh, right. The very first thing I did.
He's awake now, isn't he?
Yeah, he's totally awake.
Yeah. You get one free hit the first time you fight him.
Can I just stand in this poison? Or no?
If it isn't affecting you, then it means, yes, you can stand where you're standing. But, like, you can't stand in it.
I mean, it doesn't seem to be doing a lot of damage, is all I'm saying.
It should be filling up a bar. Shouldn't be doing any damage.
Right. And the bar doesn't get super full, is all I'm saying.
Oh, okay. I mean, if it gets filled, you can stand it in for as long as you like. I mean, if it gets filled, you're gonna be mildly fucked.
If that one hit. That's probably the most frustrating, is like, I don't know if any of this is hitting him.
The range is kind of weird.
Geez. There was one of those, like, swipe attacks you were talking about.
Yeah, luckily they don't do a ton of damage.
No?
Have you hit him at all?
Yeah, I hit him a few times. The problem is, like, the exact timing that the poison stops, he pulls his paw back. I just keep whiffing his paw, and it's messed up.
I also think the poison actually starts to dissipate before it looks like it's dissipating, so you can, like, run in there. Does the poison have a hitbox? I don't remember. Been a while since I've been hit by it.
Like, I don't really know.
When you're standing in it, does it hit you?
Yes.
Like, does it cause a stagger on your character?
Oh, it doesn't seem to, no.
Does it cause damage when you're standing in it? Like, damage, like, directly to your health bar, or is it only building the poison thing?
It does a little bit of damage to my health bar. I think I'll be fine.
Okay, what's its health at?
Fall off the map. A second. It's a little under half.
Okay.
Three quarters away. Man. I don't know. It's hard to explain.
It's not easy to get the timing right. It takes it's a weirdly long fight.
I'm doing it very poorly as well. I don't know if...
Yeah.
Wow. Like, I directly hit his paw that time, and it didn't deal damage. I don't know. I feel like to people who know what's going on here, they're like, boy, this is just bad.
Need to do is get through it. I actually don't even know if there's like a legitimate way to fight this enemy. This is the way I've always done this fight.
Yeah.
Honestly. Yeah.
Alright, I think he's dead.
Okay, I mean, you should know.
Yeah, he's dying. Dragon okay. Scale.
None of the really the like you're not really gonna use any of the stuff you pick up here, but you get the free souls and he doesn't respawn.
That's good.
So
Dragon
you can pick up
Crest Shield.
Yeah, Dragon Crest Shield, that's not a bad shield.
Not be a
sword
bad shield.
Also.
Get a decent amount of souls.
Enough to level up?
No. I think I need over 6,000 now to level up. I'm at 3,000.
He gives way less than I thought.
Yeah. I'm walking back across the bridge.
Did you get all the items that were on the ground? Like the sword
yes,
and the...
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
Sword, crest, and there's a soul.
Yeah. Again, like not like you're going to use a whole lot of stuff. Your soul's always, obviously always useful. So yeah, let's head into that cave.
Okay. Very green, again.
Yeah. There may be some frame rate things that happen in this zone. Even though on the PC version, yeah, it might get kind of weird toward the bottom, so just be ready for that. But we're going to head, just follow the tunnel and kill all ogres.
Death to the ogres, got it. These guys can really take a hit. Jesus.
You can backstab them too. They're like actually super easy to backstab.
Oh.
Because their backs are massive and they're slow as shit.
Oh, okay. You always say that, but don't I have to do like a roll to get behind them and everything?
Not necessarily. Like if you're locked on, you can usually just like strafe behind them. They're really, really slow. Most enemies in the game, you can pretty much just walk behind and backstab.
Getting a lot of these dung pie.
Yeah, those are gross.
Yeah.
And I don't really foresee any instance where you'll use them. They also, like, they build poison on you when you throw them, so...
Oh, yeah?
Like, they're just as harmful as they are helpful.
Gosh. I did a backstab to one.
Nice.
Ooh. He's dead. Alright, cool. So I don't actually have to collect these dung pie then. I could probably just let him go.
I don't think they only drop dung pies. They do drop their club at some point, which you could use.
Okay. Alright, I'm walking out of that cave entrance. BLIGHTTOWN title has appeared.
Okay, so this is where it's going to be real hard to describe to you where to go. But our ultimate goal is to climb down, just be climbing down ladders. Until we get to the elevator contraption.
Can't just jump straight down.
Jump straight down.
There's a chest up here. Do I need to open this chest?
Yeah. Yes, open the chest, but it's not going to be anything that's going to be useful to you.
Key to new Londo ruins.
Yeah, that's the key to the door that you came through to get in here. That we opened with the skeleton key. Master key.
What? Oh, right. You said we were.
Yeah, so this is the exit of the zone. Yeah, normally you would be walking, you would be working your way up from the bottom because you come in. So the depths leads to a door that leads into like another area of BLIGHTTOWN that you work your way down to the bottom and then you fight the boss and then you work your way back up the other side and you exit where you're at right now. But we're going to skip all that stuff, go straight down from this side and then fight the boss and then come back straight back up the way you came in.
Thing goes down way farther than it probably should.
Oh yeah.
And like what I said, is that? A wheel well.
Oh, okay. So that's the elevator.
What?
That's where we're headed. Yeah, that thing. So that thing is basically, it's got like, imagine
being gross.
Imagine if wrapped around it is like I don't know what you would, like a timing belt for like a tire. So like there's like a belt that wraps around that that well of made of ropes that then has platforms that move. So that wheel is spinning the platforms up and over and then down to another platform at the bottom. So you want to like ride them. Ride the moving platforms down from the top to the bottom.
For real?
You only have to get on one, yeah. But you have to get there first, which is down a series of ladders.
That sounds awful.
It's really not that bad. May have some amount of trouble timing it to get onto the platform. It's, if you don't like stress yourself out over it, it's not too bad. But I have, on a number of occasions, missed the platform. Which is a certain death.
Okay. There's a lot of these mosquitoes.
Giving you toxic. So the mosquitoes, they're giving you not toxic. I'm pretty sure it's poison. No. The dudes, there will be dudes with, then those are the dudes with the blowtarts.
Blowtarts?
Blowtarts.
Oh. Oh yeah, he's right there. Okay. You said not to go the direction of blowtarts.
No,
guy, right?
You want to go back, continue down ladders.
Where was there another ladder? Did I miss it?
Yes. Apparently. It's right next to the ladder where that leads you down to where the blow dart guys are.
Right next to that ladder?
Like to the left of it? Or to the right of it if you're facing out toward BLIGHTTOWN, I think.
So I would have to go toward blow dart guy?
No. To the right of him. Like to the right of... If you get on that platform, he should be on your left.
No, he's
if
on my
right.
If
you're facing BLIGHTTOWN. If you're facing BLIGHTTOWN...
Oh, okay, yeah, facing BLIGHTTOWN.
So to your right should be another ladder that leads down.
Yeah, well, there's like a platform. Ooh, I assume a ladder. I'm really low in health because of the poisons.
Yeah, well, you need to heal yourself through it. I mean, if we get to the bottom, it will not be a problem. But the toxic is really the issue.
Let me look. I'm close. Okay, I have to walk across some tree branches.
No, you thing? Shouldn't. You shouldn't have to. That's no? the wrong way. Okay. You want to continue going toward the other direction.
Well, I fell down.
Okay.
I fell. Boy, that's confusing. I see the belt thing, though.
Okay. You shouldn't ever this need to walk across those branches.
Alright, yeah.
Well, once plus we get to the bottom, like, this is the hardest part. Once we get to the bottom, then everything's easy. Well, relatively yeah. easy. As far as direction okay. should go.
Man. I don't know. I wasn't sure where I was going. The ladder
it's
wasn't.
Fine. It's really easy to get lost, simple. But you don't want to head where that blow dart guy is. Don't ever go that direction. You'll never need to until you get to the bottom. You want to continue to head toward the wheel well in that direction.
Okay. I'm just heading back.
Yeah, yeah.
Again, very interesting elevators in this game. I don't think I've found one that was similar to the last. I guess this one's probably the most similar to some of the others.
Yeah, mechanically there's a lot that are the same, but they're all, like, different elevators. Wait until you see the longest ladder in the game.
Yeah.
Boy.
Is there, like, a sign that says, longest ladder? There
no. Should be. It should be. However, I did have a time once where I was playing, I don't remember, it was a long time ago, on, like, the Xbox 360 version, and I climbed to the top of said ladder, and as I was climbing, I got invaded. And I guess the person who invaded me didn't know that the ladder was there. And yeah. I was standing at the top of the ladder watching them run around at the bottom of the zone looking for me until eventually they just jumped off the map and died. I guess they got bored.
Wow. What an interesting thing. Can't leave a world once you've invaded it?
You totally can, actually. I don't think they knew how.
Oh, okay. Odd. I'm back to the ogres.
Okay, murderer said ogres. Did you run into those flamethrower things? I know there's one on the way to the ladders.
I don't think so.
The weird deformed things that shoot fire.
Oh, yeah. I killed one right when I got down to the very bottom of that ladder.
Okay, yeah. That they shoot fire, if you never got that far.
I actually watched him shooting fire as I was stabbing him.
Yeah, they're kind of pyromancers, I guess. Kind of.
Yes.
I don't really know the lore behind those things that well. I should look that up.
How is he not dead? Man, is magic pixeling himself to death. I mean, life. He's dead. One more. Give me your dung. Man. Don't isolate that audio.
Too late.
What I was doing there, I was trying to do like a charge attack. It didn't really work. They like to do that thing where they call their friends.
Yeah, which I don't think actually does anything in that area.
It doesn't seem to be effective there, no.
There are ogres that have that. I mean, they all have the same moveset, but there are more of them in the beginning of that area where that's much more effective.
Oh.
Because there's a lot of little dudes. An enemy type, I think you won't even see.
You would normally be like afraid of that?
Probably.
Man, what a weird place. What is that thing? Jesus. None of this is right. None of this is good for anyone.
Where are you at currently?
Oh god, that thing looks so crazy. The fire thing is what I just
okay.
did.
Remember, you can slide down ladders, because that's important for that guy that's shooting toxic darts. For him not to actually give you toxic, you have to get down those ladders pretty fucking fast.
Okay.
And also get kind of lucky. Like, hope he misses.
Right.
Vaguely random. And actually, we may want to go over there at some point and kill him and kill the stuff that's over there. It's a really kind of rough little zone. Like,
remember like 5 seconds ago when you said we'd never
no,
have to go
we're not
going to
do it now. And we don't technically ever have to. You'll never have to go across the branches. But,
man, what was the year last time? I don't know. Okay. So I made it down this ladder. Okay, there's a lot. Another ladder. I'm just not sure what I'm going to run into, and I'm getting freaked out. Okay.
Yeah, it's mostly going to be those mosquitoes. So those fucking flying mosquitoes, they just keep showing up.
Yeah.
They will not stop showing up. They spawn infinitely in this entire zone.
That's frustrating.
Yes, it's God, incredibly annoying. Did you fall?
Oh my god, I'm not dead. I am dead. Dang it. Yes. For a second there, I thought I landed on something and was fine, but no, I died.
Yeah.
So, just getting to a location is going to be the boss battle of this one, everybody. Buckle in.
Yeah, I mean, that's the zone. Like, that's the danger of doing, like, this part. I feel doing this part, I mean, maybe not as for your first time, I don't know, but doing this Blighttown this way is still, even though this is a fucking nightmare of trying to traverse this wooden hell, it's still easier than going in Blighttown the traditional way. It's also much faster.
I don't know. It doesn't feel that way. I don't know what the other way's like, but I can't say.
Well, you'd have to do a whole other zone and a boss and then a whole other zone. So, like, the size of the Undead Burg, or bigger. But probably longer, because there's much more poison and petrification danger.
Petrification?
Yeah, there's basilisks in the,
Alright, we're gonna stay going the way we're going. I don't need to deal with basilisks.
Oh, you don't have a choice. You're gonna have to deal with basilisks eventually. But, well, maybe not.
Valley of Drakes.
I'm gonna make sure you deal with them at some point.
Well, that's nice of you.
Eventually. They're too weird not to see, at least.
Well, they have giant fake eyes. Pretty weird stuff. What? How do you know they're fake?
Because you can see their real eyes.
Oh. Oh, okay. I thought you meant, like, they had, like, a glass eye or something.
Oh, no.
How can you tell it's fake? How do you even know? Ow. Ogres, by the way. That's all I'm dealing with right now.
Yeah, I figured. Kill any of them yet?
I killed one of them.
Backstabbing any of them yet?
Backstabbing one right now.
Yeah, see, that's not that bad.
No, backstab is oh, he's relatively not dead.
Yeah, they usually...
he did not die by it.
I think you can hit them while they're getting up, too. Like, if you time the heavy attack right, you can pretty much get it to, so as soon as they hit, stand up, they get hit.
I kind of assumed that that backstab would kill him. I don't know why. I just really... Mostly it was just hoping, I mean... I basically cleaved the guy in half.
The backstab with his Y-hand is really weird, too.
It's basically the same as the axe.
Yes. A lot of them are that way.
Are the same as the axe?
Yeah.
That's a shame.
That same animation.
Ooh. Oh, he's killed me. Really? Right here? Man. I'm bad at this game. Turns out, I'm trash. I'm garbage.
Did you die at the last ogre? What happened?
Yeah, the last ogre killed me.
Yeah.
Got me with a big swing, and then I didn't get back up by the time he swung again.
Back to the fight. Keep going. This is Dark Souls.
I don't know.
Maybe, I mean, I don't know. At least the one advantage of this is, like, past the ogres, there aren't really that many enemies. There's that... The weird abominations and the mosquitoes.
The mosquitoes are mostly, like... I'm trying... That's what happened last time. I fell off because of the mosquitoes. I didn't tell you that because I was mostly embarrassed.
Well, I would have seen it on the video.
Yeah, but that would have been, like, however long from now.
Your recurring embarrassment.
You would have made fun of me later, not currently.
I think being knocked off the platform is less embarrassing than fumbling off like a Mr. Magoo.
Well, I fumbled off trying not to be poisoned to death, which would be way worse, I think, being poisoned to death. So I'm like, being successful, and then I just fall over dead because I'm garbage. That would have sucked. I almost fell off a freaking little wood bridge just walking to the ogres. This game is not for me.
I would tell you to put the moss on, but since we have a limited supply of it, you can buy it from that one lady in the tunnel. And it drops off the trees pretty commonly in the Darkroot Garden area. But I think you should be able to make it down to the bottom without using the moss. And if we make it that far, then you can use one just to make sure you make it to the bonfire.
Ugh, God, I'm gonna die to him again, I know it.
The ogres?
Yeah, they freaking did it again.
Just take it slow.
Well, you know, it's easy to say when you're not dead.
Are you dead?
Yes, I am dead.
Just gotta... I mean, are you fighting them two at a time?
So, that time, I did a dumb thing, and yes. But But the last time, I only got hung up on the last one. So.
Well, that
you say take your time, and then I shortcut down the steps.
Yeah.
And almost fall off into oblivion. A whole nother game.
Have you been sending that elevator back up for yourself?
Yes, every time.
Okay.
And we didn't talk about it, like, on a video, so people either are like, oh, he's really smart, or wondering what the heck I'm doing it for.
Eventually, you're like, the problem with this method is that there will come a time where you're going to forget that one time. And it might not even be this elevator, but there will be a time where you forget to send an elevator back up and expect it and just fall straight to your death. Almost guaranteed that's going to happen. There's enough elevators in this game
that it's going to happen.
You die enough, like, just in general, like, playing through these games, that it's just way likely. The likelihood is high. It's most high, I think, in this particular run.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you have quite a distance to get from where you're going to where you need to be. And you just get frustrated and start running.
Let me recover all of my not souls. Come on, guy. Come over here.
There is another bonfire. God, I can't talk today. There's another bonfire not terribly far from that, like, valley. The Valley of the Drakes is what that area is called.
Yes.
I don't know that it's closer than Firelink. It wouldn't be as kindled either, so you wouldn't get as many flasks.
Not even as kindled. Really hoping I would hit before him. Well, let's try it again. Poisoned. These guys poisoned me.
Oh yeah, they poisoned you. Everything in Blighttown poisons you. Everything in Blighttown. It's covered in shit.
That's messed up. Got these dungs.
There's a lore thing in the depths. I think it's on the key to the depths at the end of that zone that basically says the dudes in the depths, which are a bunch of fucking rats and undead and like giant fucking mouth dragon. It's terrifying to look at. It's like those terrible inhabitants and disgusting folk locked away Blighttown because they were like, I don't want that shit coming up to our sewer.
Funny.
So, Blighttown's pretty fucking bad. Hence the name Blighttown.
Blighttown, yeah. They don't give those names just for no reason.
No. Not typically. I'm pretty sure every single enemy in that area applies some form of poison or terrible shit.
Yeah. Blighttown. Is there no shortcuts I can take?
No. This is the shortcut.
I meant, like, I can't just jump down.
Oh, not in any way that's reasonable. Thing. Like, the ladders are much easier than any other thing. You're like, you can fall down a couple of those ladders and survive, but the damage you take plus the poison, you may not actually survive.
Basically, right now, I think I'm just going ladder to ladder, and I'm trying to get to the next ladder as quick as I can so as not to get dealt with by
that is mosquitoes. The idea. I mean, you can kill the mosquitoes.
Well, yeah, take but one without hit. Falling off. Well, I got toxic on me, unfortunately. Which means one of the darts.
It means you're going to have to heal a lot more. It's best to let your health work it down as low as possible before you use a flask, too. That way you're maximizing your flask usage. Okay. What killed you?
Well, a combination of the poison, the toxin, and then the fire dude at the bottom of the ladder that was there as I was getting to the bottom of the ladder and couldn't get off fast enough.
Yeah. You can,
maybe we should, like...
I
don't know. Cut to me there.
Okay.
I can what?
Well, I was gonna say if the platform is small enough, you can always plunging attack off of it.
I thought about it.
If that's the situation, but again, the toxic and the poison's a lot of damage to be taking.
Mosquitoes. I'll give it one more crawl run. If I can't make it there, I'm just gonna do some magical cuts.
Some type of cool video editing.
Or lame video editing work. Huh. Hard to say. Where is your favorite area of the game?
Mine?
Yes. And have I been there?
Oh, no. It's, you'll be there soon. I've grown to really like Sense Fortress because, I can run through it now with, like, relative ease. It's, like, almost... You can... Sense Fortress is, like, one of those areas where, it's the area you'll be going right after this. Like, right after you kill this boss. It's, like, the last fuck you before you get into the real meat of the game.
Yeah.
Where it is just a castle filled with booby traps. It's literally a castle that has giant swinging guillotines, like, a la cartoon-style fucking craziness. Like, designed by a mad scientist or a supervillain or something, where it's just fucking giant swinging guillotines from the ceiling, and arrow traps, and fucking snake men that shoot lightning. It's all terrible. It's got a tar pit in it. Got a giant boulder. Got a giant boulder. Bigger than the boulder from before.
Yeah.
And fucking way worse. Yeah, it's kind of a nightmare the first time through it. If you don't know any of the traps are coming. But like once you learn all the traps, it's an area that you can get through. I'd say most people probably spend several hours there the first time they encounter it. Especially if you were not like not using a guide or anything. You could probably spend quite a few hours there. It's an area now that I can get through in like 20 minutes.
Well, you'll have to tell me when we're actually there. Well, I'm sure it'll pop up on screen. I'll be like, hey, this is that place.
But like now that I've like kind of like mastered it and I know everything that area has to offer, I really appreciate that area. I think it's really cool. Yeah. And I think it adds there's a lot of cool elements about it. And then where that goes is maybe one of the coolest looking areas in Dark Souls and probably my tie for favorite.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll see it in a little bit. I'll point it out after we get there.
The ogres are all dead.
Alright, back to the elevator madness. So, you can try... How many mosses do you have?
I don't know, probably a bunch.
Well, check.
I'd have to. Okay.
That's the one reason I asked this question.
Let's find out. Which color or which type?
Purple.
Purple, 6.
Do you have any blooming purple?
2.
Blooming is the only thing that gets rid of toxic.
Okay.
The regular purple will get rid of poison. Toxic will do more damage, but it lasts less time. You can search through your inventory to see if you have any gear that has higher poison and toxic resist. And basically what that'll do is it'll make the bar larger for your toxic and poison buildup. And you can put those on while you're running through this zone. Because really, your like physical defense is not going to be that important. There's not really that many things hitting you with weapons.
Right. I'm going to try running it again. I don't know.
I mean, did you look at your gear?
Yeah, I didn't want to spend time just looking through it all. So no, I did not. I'm just gonna book it. Hope for the best. I'm back at where I died last time.
Okay.
Not sure where to go next.
Well, head toward the wheel. Are you above the wheel, or are you, like, away
from
it still?
I have to go down another line. I am near the wheel. I'm fairly close, I think.
Eventually, the platform you should get to should leave you kind of past the wheel to the other side of it, and then down another ladder, and then that loops back to a platform that will be toward the cliff, like, next to the wall.
Yeah.
Okay, and that should have... Are you in front of the platforms that are, like, being elevated down?
Yes.
Okay, you want to walk off onto one of those platforms on its way down. Kind of watch the timing.
Real?
Yes. You don't have to jump or roll or anything. You just have to step off onto the platform.
Is it the other side?
Is it the other side?
I'm confused.
I don't know what you mean.
They're going down, right?
Yes.
Give me a second.
Hold on. I want to make sure you're at the right place. Is the, this is where it gets really difficult to describe. So the wheel is spinning clockwise, right?
Yes.
Okay. Are you on the side? So the side you're facing is the...
There don't appear to be any platforms going... below me.
Listen, listen. Is the side that's going down to your left or to your right?
It depends which way I'm facing.
If you're facing,
you want me to be.
If you're facing,
if I'm looking at it, it's going to my right.
Going to your
downward
right.
Downward to my right.
Okay, that's where you want to be standing.
Okay. Do I want to be where the platforms are, like, coming toward me, or do I want to actually be at it from the side?
You want to be at it. Well, I don't think you can be at it from where they're coming toward you. I think you have to be on the side.
Oh, I think I could walk off right here. Anyway, so where am I headed once I'm on one?
Just down until it gets to the it'll go right down to another, like, a big dock area. You'll know when to get off.
It'll be the only, it'll be this. The... I don't know if this is the right place, but I'm gonna risk this.
Man, I don't know either.
Well, I fell.
Okay. Well, then we're gonna call it an episode. Review the tapes and see what was going on. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you next time, and hopefully we'll be in Blighttown.
Bye.
Bye.